Hi everyone, how's it going? Thao here. Most of us spend a lot of time on our phones, however, aren't utilizing it to its full capability. Modern smartphones come with a lot of multitasking and time-saving features that are often overlooked. Samsung is one of the manufacturers that is constantly pushing their vision for smartphone productivity. App Pair is an example of this. It's a feature that lets you open directly into a split-screen session with two apps of your choosing. In today's video, I'm going to demonstrate how to set up an App Pair on the Samsung Galaxy S9. I'll also be going over my favorite app pair combinations that are convenient and extremely useful. Let's get right into it. Before I get into my app pair combination, let's quickly go over the two ways you can set up app pair shortcuts. The first way is via the app's edge panel on the edge screen. If you don't have the edge screen enabled, you'll have to do so by going to settings. Click on display, scroll down until you see edge screen, and make sure the edge panel is turned on. Once it's on, you can swipe in from the edge where there's a little indicator, then hit the settings icon. Make sure you have the app's edge panel turned on. Click the edit button. Click on create app pair. From here, you can select the apps of your choosing. You can also change which app you want to launch on the top by clicking the switch button found here. Hit done at the top and your newly created app pair will now appear on your app's edge panel. The second way allows you to add an app pair shortcut directly to the home screen. This is something I didn't even know about. It was one of my awesome subscribers by the name of TPAR69 who let me know that this was possible. And that's why I love the S9 so much. I feel like I'm discovering new functions and features all the time. To create an app pair shortcut for your home screen, you'll need to launch two apps into split screen mode. So for example, let's open YouTube and then open another random app. In the middle of both apps, you'll see a small bar. Tap that and a pop-up menu will appear. From there, hit the house symbol with the plus inside of it. The current split screen apps that you are using will now be added to your home screen. Pretty awesome. So now that you know how to create app pair shortcuts, here are my favorite app pair combinations. The first one is camera and gallery. This pairing allows you to take photos and manage your newly captured photos all at the same time. Switching back and forth between the camera and gallery can be very time consuming. You can also potentially miss a great photo opportunity while admiring your photos. I use this a lot for family and social outings to quickly check group photos. This allows me to ensure that everyone's looking directly at the camera and that nobody's eyes are closed. Definitely try this out. The second app pair is Google Maps and Pocket Casts. Whenever I'm driving, I always like to have Google Maps guiding me. I also enjoy listening to podcasts while I'm driving, and this app pair allows me to do both while still focusing on the road. It's much safer as I don't have to switch away from Google Maps or swipe down the notification panel to rewind or fast forward an episode. Listening to educational podcasts is a great way to learn something new while being stuck in rush hour traffic. The next app pair is essential when traveling abroad, and it's Google Maps paired with Google Translate. I used this combination during my entire trip to Japan earlier this year. The ability to translate via typing, voice, or the camera with Google Lens is amazing for overcoming the language barrier. I used Google Maps to navigate and Google Translate to decode any words or signs I couldn't read. When I did get lost, I was able to use Google Voice translations to get directions from the locals.
Konnichiwa, genki desu ka?
Fourth highly used app pair is YouTube with internet or Reddit. Being able to watch YouTube while surfing the web or browsing through Reddit is a great way to wind down after a long hard day. This pairing is especially useful when I'm watching a product review and want to quickly search up an item. I can look up prices online without having to exit out the video. The fifth combination is internet and internet. This is pretty self-explanatory. You can run two instances of web browsing at once. Similar to how you can run multiple tabs on your computer or laptop, it's just really nice to be able to do this on your smartphone as well. An example of how I would use this is when I'm comparing products or prices on different retailers' websites. It's not the most green real estate, but it does the job. The final app pair is Clock and Google Drive. I have all my workout routines uploaded to Google Drive for easy access. To time my rest period and intervals, I use the stopwatch feature on the Samsung Clock app. This is extremely useful during my workouts as I'm able to follow my routine and stay on track with timing in between my sets. With summer here, I'll be using this pair a lot during my outdoor workouts. That's a wrap! What are some of your favorite app pair combinations? Let me know in the comment section down below. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button. As always, it's much appreciated. And don't forget to subscribe on your way out so you don't miss any future videos of mine. Until the next one, peace.